What if you could build a complete data pipeline from Salesforce to BigQuery using nothing but natural language? Today, I'm going to show you how Keboola's new MCP server integration lets you do exactly that. Instead of clicking through dozens of configuration screens, we'll simply tell Claude what we want to accomplish and watch as it automatically sets up extractors and writers, all through simple conversation. Before we dive in, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel to see more ways that your business can leverage Keboola to simplify your data processes. Let's jump right into Claude. So looking at Claude here, so the only thing that I've really done so far is I have my credentials set inside of Keboola for Salesforce and BigQuery, and I've also already installed the MCP inside of Claude. Be looking out for a video that talks about how to do that inside of Claude, but you can also check our documentation. I'll have that link below. So the way that you can know that your MCP is installed is if you click on the plus sign, you can see add from Keboola. And you can see some jobs here. So there's more jobs than what you can see just on this little menu. If you search, you can find more. But that's what's allowing us to do this inside of Claude. So let's just go ahead and type and see what happens. So I'm going to say, hey, Claude. Always like to be nice to our AI overlords. I think it's really, really important. So if things go bad, they're nice to us, which I think is really good. So I'm going to say, use the Keboola MCP server to create a flow that extracts data from Salesforce and writes it into BigQuery. So tell them exactly what we want. I'm going to say I'd like to extract the following Salesforce tables. So of course you could just say I want to extract all of them. There's a lot of tables in Salesforce, but it would do it for you if you wanted to. I'm just going to do a small sample here. So I'm going to do the calendar, log, group, and group member. So that works there. So I'm going to do that. Of course, you can add some more settings here and tell it to do other, like if you wanted to write a transformation, you can do that for you. We're going to keep this pretty simple on this one, but of course, it can write transformations for you as well inside of SQL. Excuse me, that would be great as well. So anyways, go ahead and run this thing. So you can see, we're going to just walk through as it says. So the first thing it's going to do is find the component ID. That's one of the jobs in our MCP server. So that component is the Salesforce extractor. So that's obviously what is extracting the data from Salesforce. Second component, probably BigQuery writer. Sure enough, there it is. So that's the two components that we'd want. Of course, if you're using the MCP server for Keboola and it can't find a component that does what it wants, it'll actually help you write that component for you as well, which I think is really great. So if there's a component that we don't have pre-built inside of Keboola, this MCP server is going to help kind of power you up to create that on your own, especially for businesses that have less technical members, which is great. Retrieving component configuration, so just grabbing those IDs for that as well. Going down, so it says, great, I see you have some Salesforce and BigQuery configuration set up. Of course, if you didn't, it would help you walk through that as well. And it says, I noticed that you have a calendar extraction already configured, so we already have that one, but you'll need configurations for log, group, and group members as well. So it's going to first check the details of the existing configuration and then create the missing ones. So it's grabbing that configuration. So you can see I have it set up here. So all the information there. So that's great. And it says, let me create the missing row configurations for log, group, and group members. If you've used Keboola, you know that we set those up in rows inside of that configuration. So you can see it's grabbing that there and putting, there's the log, so on and so forth there. We won't walk through all of that. And it says, let me adjust the parameters without the field array since it's empty. So it's doing that for us there. So just walking through that. It says the schema is strict about the enum values, so let me use some custom queries instead to extract the specific tables that you need. So that's great there. So again, just continuing down, doing the group configuration, doing the group member configuration, and then now it's checking the existing BigQuery writer to understand how it's set up. So it's looking at that one that we had before. Remember, I just had those set up just because of the credentials were in there. We're going to check the tables in the Salesforce bucket to make sure that they're all there. So that's good there. And so it says that the tables are already created. And so now it's creating the BigQuery writer configurations for those tables. So it's grabbing those details of the tables, creating the row configuration for the log table. So you can see it's giving us that, and it's even writing descriptions for us, which I think is really great as well. So it's kind of helping that some of that busy work, I would call it, that data engineers or just data people in general have to do, writing descriptions, writing titles and things like that. It is handling that for you as well. So it's not just leaving that stuff blank, which is wonderful. So you can see it did it for the group table, did it for the group member table. And then what I really love about our MCP server is it does a really great job of telling you what it's doing. So it says, let me create the flow that orchestrates these components. I need to gather all the configuration IDs for the flow. So there's all of our configuration IDs for the Salesforce, the root Salesforce extractor, so the, kind of the big house that they all sit in, and then each individual one. And now it's actually creating that workflow for us. You can see the name is Salesforce to BigQuery flow. The description is orchestrates the extraction of calendar, log, group member data from Salesforce and writes it inside of BigQuery. And then you can see each phase. So there's the extract phase and the write phase there. So it's, this one only has two phases, but obviously you can make this as complicated as you want to. Add transformations, maybe you send this data, not just to BigQuery, but send it to like maybe a Google Sheet or S3 bucket or something like that as well. So they would do those for us as well. So it's creating the flow with the proper task structure. And then now it says perfectly, I've created a comprehensive flow that orchestrates the extraction of data from Salesforce and writes it into BigQuery. So let me provide you with a summary of what has been set up. So basically now it's telling us exactly what happened. So Salesforce to BigQuery flow summary. So it tells us it configured these four, or these eight components, four for each. Breaks down the flow structure. So phase one that runs in parallel is going to extract all that. Phase two also runs in parallel, is writing all the data. So the data destination, so all data will be written into the BigQuery dataset demos in that specific project with the following tables there. So now it says the flow is now ready to run and will orchestrate the entire ETL process from Salesforce to BigQuery in the proper sequence that it just set for us, ensuring data extraction completes before writing begins. So it sounds like, based on Claude, that everything is set up inside of Keboola exactly like we want it to. Now what we're going to do is we're going to jump inside of Keboola and just kind of look and see what was created, see if we need to clean anything up, and then we'll actually run it and then see the results inside of BigQuery. So let's jump into Keboola and see what it looks like.
So hopping out of Claude back into Keboola, you can see that the flow that Claude created using the MCP server is sitting inside of the flows here. So you can see we have our Salesforce to BigQuery flow. So we can click into that, and you can see what was created here. So we can see there is the four tables from Salesforce that are being set to being extracted. Then we have our four different tasks that are sending that data into BigQuery. And just to kind of like click into these and see how they were set up real quick. So clicking into Salesforce, you can see this is the row that is doing the calendar export. So if I edit configuration, you can see obviously my credentials are set in there. And then I can come down here into calendar and you can see like set up object name calendar view. You can see we're doing a full load. Of course, you can do a incremental load if you need to. Obviously not for this. We're just doing some sample data from Salesforce. So don't need incremental, but there's a lot of options here that you can set up if you need to. So it looks like that's set up correctly. And then I can go back into a BigQuery writer or data destination here. And you can see this one's also doing the calendar view. So it's writing that Salesforce data as a calendar view in. You can click edit configuration here. You can see we have a description written out. And you can see if I click into calendar view here, you can see there is that table, the calendar view table that we're pulling in. It's going to go into BigQuery and call itself Salesforce_calendar_view. We're doing a full load. Again, we couldn't do incremental if we need to. And then down here on the bottom is where we have all of our columns. So Claude, using the MCP server, tried to specify the data types of all these columns. So like name is a string, ID is a string, so on and so forth down there. Of course, it doesn't know your data as well as you do. But you might need to come in here and fix some of those if you want to. But you know, obviously, it's pretty good across the board across there. The only things that I've noticed that could potentially need some use or some, you know, some actual human interaction is like if your date has a timestamp. So date and timestamp in BigQuery are different. So that could potentially be something you want to edit, but other than that, it's great. So going back to our flow there, so we have all of our things set up. So we're going to extract from Salesforce. Once they're all finished, we're going to load that into BigQuery. I can come up here and click run flow. Go and click run. And you can see our job has been scheduled. And so you can see our circle starting to spin here. So these four are about to start working together. While that's happening, you can see there's those circles going there. I want to talk real quick about how you can schedule this thing to run. So if you want this thing to run on a schedule, of course, the MCP server doesn't have the job just yet, but it's coming very, very soon. But can actually add your schedule to run like every day at 8 a.m., every day at 4 p.m., multiple times a day. So you can do that inside of our schedule tab here. We do have notifications inside of Keboola as well. So if this thing runs and fails, You can always pop in there and send an email to yourself, or like call webhook to call, you know, send a Slack message to a channel or a Teams message or whatever channel you want to send that to, that can work there. And then over here on the right side, we have our versions tab here. So everything inside of Keboola is actually backed up by version control. So you can revert back to old versions and things like that. So with our version control there, obviously we're in version one. But, you know, as you build onto this thing, you know, as you can use the MCP to continue to build onto this specific flow, you know, maybe we want to add some transformations in there, or maybe we want to like export something that's not Salesforce into BigQuery as well. You can see those versions as they continue to stack there. So what we're seeing on our screen now is that this thing is completely done. So everything's been extracted from Salesforce. Everything's been loaded into BigQuery. So I want to show you, you know, I don't want you to just have to believe me that these green check marks could mean nothing. So I want to show you this actually works. So if I go into storage here, you can see in our Salesforce folder, we have our calendar view data. I'm just clicking on one, for example. You can see the data that got loaded in last imports a minute ago, 8.7 kilobytes of data, not much there. You can see our column names and then a sample value. I can actually go into a data sample and take a look and see at the data that's actually sitting inside of that table. So I just wanted to show that we did actually pull some data in. And then what's even cooler is I can come into BigQuery, refresh this, and then we can see we have our Salesforce calendar view, like we said. And you can see there's all those columns again with all the types that we set up. So you can see the timestamp was a big one. So the timestamp for date is important. And then I can come into BigQuery and click on preview. And you can see there is that exact same data set that we just saw inside of Keboola, now inside of BigQuery. And there you have it, a complete Salesforce to BigQuery pipeline built entirely through conversation with Claude. No manual configuration, no hunting through documentation, just natural language instructions that get translated into production-ready data workflows. This is just the beginning of what's possible when you combine Keboola's powerful data platform with AI assistance. The MCP server works with Claude, Cursor, and other AI tools, so you can integrate this approach into whatever development environment you're already using. Data engineering just got a whole lot more intuitive, and this is only the start. If you want to see more videos just like this one, make sure you just subscribe to our channel. I'll see you next time.